program. Thank you for staying with us here on KTN Prime. Now, today, the President, Uhuru Kenyatta, did launch the biometric registration of public servants. Now, in studio, to just shed some more light on that, we bring in Hassan Nura, Senior Director at the Ministry of Devolution and Planning. Thank you for joining us, sir. And David Owiro from the Institute of Economic Affairs. Let me start with you, my Director. How does the biometric registration seek to cleanse the payroll of ghost workers? And do you have a timeline for this? How soon do you expect to have this?
I must say the biometric system that has just been launched today by His Excellency the President is a program that is intended to make sure that the ghost workers are removed from the payroll. But more importantly, I think this exercise has been made to make sure that we restructure and facilitate the transformation of the public service into a more efficient and effective public service that provides very efficient public service to its citizens and also which is result oriented. And I have no doubt the time frame as for this program is going to, the first phase is going to be from July. It's kicked off in July, sensitization and training program, which kicked off in July this year, and the first phase of data collection is going to end up in October. And within that time we should have been able to capture enough data during that period.
So October. Now, this program is part of the wider capacity assessment and rationalization of public service program, that is CAPS. Now, through this, or as a result of this program, are public servants going to lose their jobs?
Public servants are not going to lose their jobs, but the more emphasis that we're going to put on this exercise is the competency and skills to be in line with the functions that people are doing. I think our emphasis more is about productivity. As you know very well, in 2010, we enacted a new constitution, which constitution demanded for a complete change of overhaul on how we deliver services. Our basic fundamental human rights have been enhanced. And for us to achieve this, we should be able to make sure that our services are restructured, our competence and skills are matched with the people who are doing the right job. That really is the core issue here. And it's not about people losing jobs.
Okay.
It's about making people more efficient than they have been.
Now, obviously, this particular program is aimed towards, you know, making the governments, both the national and county governments, more efficient, and that has brought about the discussion about the public wage bill, which has been ongoing for the last 2 years or so. And let's now bring in David Owiro from the Institute of Economic Affairs. David, do you think this is enough, you know, to solve the problem of a ballooning public wage bill once and for all?
Well, thank you for that question. I think. In our view at the Institute of Economic Affairs, when we look at the issue of the wage bill, the concern has been that we have inefficiency, particularly within the public service, that ends up costing the taxpayer a lot of money. And when you talk about fiscal consolidation in terms of how government spends its money, we argue that there could be better ways if we were to solve the inefficiency issues in the within the wage bill. And so one major concern has been the so-called ghost workers, which is a small subset of a big problem called the payroll fraud. And in this case, the assumption that government is making is that there are some people who perhaps earn wages and yet they don't work within the public service for one reason or another. Maybe they dropped out, maybe they transferred, maybe they were dead, and so their salaries still continue to come. Obviously this will is basically a headcount in some sense, though they are getting more data points for it. They're getting, you know, physical you know, pictures and so on, but it's basically a headcount, and that will go a long way in terms of us knowing the real numbers within the public sector, which is something that that is important.
From where you said, do you think it will catch or, you know, rid the government or the payroll of ghost workers?
No, it's one step perhaps in the bigger set of interventions that government needs to take. For instance, when we're talking about this issue of payroll fraud, remember that within the same system, there are people who earn salaries twice. There are people who, and they're workers, they're within the system and they earn salaries twice. There are people for whom do not work but receive a paycheck. Perhaps they retired formally, but the payroll still has their details and, you know, money still comes. This perhaps will address the so-called ghosts, those who are absent from work but are earning. But when it comes to now the issue of addressing the larger wage sector issues, dealing with issues of wage differentials within the public sector, talking about rationalizing the functions of government and whether this is the best or the most appropriate or efficient system that we have, I believe we still have a long way to go. But as has been stated, this is just one of the major things that the program is supposed to be doing. My concern is on the timelines and to what extent, by what extent do they expect to reduce the wage bill? As we know, there has been claimed that we need to reduce it from about 11% of GDP to slightly, maybe some people are talking 7, some people are talking 8.
Yes.
But we need to understand, has government thought about this? What is their goal? By how much do they want to reduce this?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mona Director, one last question. Now, there have been, Kenyans have been skeptical about this program. They have been referring to the biometric voter registration that had some challenges in the last election. How foolproof is this program?
This program has been tested, and we have no doubt since we kicked off this morning, there has been a lot of test runs that has been done, dry test runs were done. It is foolproof in the sense that people are going to physically present themselves with all the papers that are required, and therefore there's no way of somebody presenting another person in the process. There are biometric data that's going to be collected, the fingerprints are going to be picked, picture photographs are going to be taken. You will be presenting original documents of your certificates and ID card, so there is no way that you can be able to create another person in this exercise.
And
I think more importantly, I think as much as we may look at the wage bill as an issue that's being addressed in many of the forums, the main issue in the public service today is about efficiency and effectiveness. Are public service efficient? Do we get value for money for all the workers that we have employed in the public service? I think this is one fundamental area that this specific area of CAPS, the rationalization program, is addressing. Institutional capacity, the workload analysis, the skills and competence matching to the right jobs that are being done by the public service. These are the areas that are really of concern. And besides, of course, exercising the ghost workers.
Yes, indeed. David, last question very quickly. What do you think should be the next, you know, area that the government looks at once they're done with this, you know, executing this exercise?
Well, a natural flow from this step, perhaps, if they're going to get the skill qualification of the workers and compare them with what the workers are actually doing within civil service, I think the logical step is now, are they actually performing as per the, you know, ministerial or departmental objectives that are set out for the year, for the period, and for the medium-term framework that we have. With that in mind, if we then have that performance metric and tie that to what people earn and the increments that they get and the bonuses that they get, that would be an important step towards making the civil service a performance-oriented workforce.
Thank you, gentlemen. Yeah. David Oro from the Institute of Economic Affairs, and Hassan Noor, Senior Director at the Ministry of Devolution and Plan. Well, we have been talking about the biometric registration of voters, and the government says that will be done by October. We shall keep an eye on that and keep you updated. Back to you, Linda.